Hello, myself MS Basargaon, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now, learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to find Fourier series of the given function. Now, we will solve the examples on Fourier series. Find the Fourier series of f of x equal to e raised to ax in the interval 0 to 2 pi. Now, we know. Let f of x is equal to a naught plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus b n sin nx. Let us call this as equation number 1. And now we can calculate a naught by the formula 1 by 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x dx, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi e raised to ax dx. Now integration of e raised to ax is 1 by 2 pi into bracket e raised to ax upon a with the limit 0 to 2 pi, which is equal to 1 by 2 a pi into e raised to ax with the limit 0 to 2 pi, which is equal to 1 by 2 a pi into bracket 2 a pi minus e raised to 0 as a 1. Now we calculate a n. A n equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x cos nx dx, which is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to 2 pi e raised to ax cos nx dx, which is equal to 1 by pi integration of e raised to ax cos nx is e raised to ax upon a square plus n square into bracket a cos nx plus n sin nx with the limit 0 to 2 pi. Since integration of e raised to ax cos bx dx is equal to e raised to ax upon a square plus b square into bracket a cos bx plus b sin bx, here comparing with this formula we get this integration. Now we can take a square plus n square outside the integral, that is 1 upon pi into bracket a square plus n square into bracket, put the upper limit, that is e raised to 2 a pi into bracket a cos of 2 n pi, and we know sine of 2 n pi is 0, therefore directly here we can write 0, minus of lower limit, that is e raised to 0 into bracket cos 0 is 1, that we can write a plus sine 0 is 0, that we can write 0, taking a common, a upon pi into bracket a square plus n square, and using cos 2 n pi as a 1, we get e raised to 2 a pi minus 1. Now, similarly, bn equal to 1 by pi into integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x sin nx dx, which is equal to 1 by pi into integration from 0 to 2 pi e raised to ax sin nx dx, which is equal to 1 by pi. Now, integrating e raised to ax sin nx, e raised to ax upon a square plus n square into bracket a sin nx minus n cos nx with the limit 0 to 2 pi. Since integration of e raised to ax sin bx dx equal to e raised to ax upon a square plus b square into bracket a sin bx minus b cos bx. Now putting the limit with 0 to 2 pi, we get 1 upon pi into bracket a square plus n square and e raised to 2 a pi sin of 2 n pi, that is 0, minus n into cos of 2 n pi minus e raised to 0 and sin 0 is 0, minus n cos 0 is 1, that is minus n. By simplifying this, we get, which is equal to taking minus n common from both, minus n upon a square plus n square into bracket here 2 a pi and here minus 1 will remain. Putting the values of a naught, a n and b n in equation number 1, by simplifying this, we can write the simplified answer as e raised to a x is equal to e raised to 2 a pi minus 1 by n into bracket 1 by 2 will remain, plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity a cos nx minus n sin nx by a square plus n square. Now, find the Fourier series of f of x equal to x in the interval 0 to 2 pi. Pause the video for a while and complete the Fourier series of the given function. I hope you have completed. This is a very simple function. Let f of x is equal to a naught plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos nx plus b n sin nx. Let us call this as equation number 1. And you can calculate a n equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x dx, that is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x is here x dx, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration of x is x square by 2 with the limit 0 to 2 pi. By putting the limit, we get pi. Similarly, a n equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x cos nx dx is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to 2 pi x cos n x dx. Again here by applying the rule of integration by part, first you will write x, integration of cos n x is sin n x by n minus derivative of x is 1, that is integration of sin n x by n is minus cos n x by n square with the limit 0 to 2 pi. As we know, sin of 2n pi is 0, minus minus plus cos of 2n pi, we get 1 by pi into bracket 1 by n square, and for lower limit minus 1 by n square, which is equal to 0. Now bn is equal to 1 by pi into integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x sin nx dx, which is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to 2 pi x sin nx dx. Again integrating by part, we get which is equal to 1 by pi into a bracket x minus cos nx by n minus 1 into minus sin nx by n square with the limit 0 to 2 pi. Now putting upper limit, we get minus 2 pi cos 2 n pi by n, and plus this second term 0, minus of lower limit because of x, here we get 0 and sin 0 is 0, which is equal to minus 2 by n. By simplifying, we get this as a Fourier series of the given function. Now we'll see Fourier series for discontinuous functions. Let f of x be defined by f of x is equal to f1 of x when 0 is less than x is less than x0, and equal to f2 of x when x0 is less than x is less than 2 pi, where x0 is the point of finite discontinuity in the interval 0 to 2 pi. Then the value of a0, an, and bn are given by a0 is equal to 1 by 2 pi. First of all, you take the limit 0 to x0, then in that f1 of x plus x0 to 2 pi f2 of x dx. Similarly, an equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to x0 f1 of x into cos nx dx plus integration from x0 to 2 pi f2 of x cos nx dx. And bn equal to 1 by pi into integration from 0 to x0 f1 of x sin nx dx plus integration from x0 to 2 pi f2 of x sin nx dx. Now we'll see the example based on discontinuous function. Find the Fourier series of f of x is equal to x when 0 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to pi, and equal to 2 pi minus x when pi is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 2 pi. Now let f of x is equal to a naught plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx plus bn sin nx, that is equation number 1. Now we'll calculate a naught, where a naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from 0 to pi, first you'll take, and in that function is x dx, plus next integration from pi to 2 pi, function is 2 pi minus x dx, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi. Now integration of x is, that is x square by 2 with the limit 0 to pi, plus integration of 2 pi minus x is 2 pi x minus x square by 2 with the limit pi to 2 pi. Now putting the limit, we get 1 by 2 pi into bracket, that is pi square by 2 minus lower limit 0, plus for the second part 2 pi into 2 pi, that is 4 pi square minus 4 pi square by 2 minus of lower limit, is that putting x equal to pi, 2 pi square minus pi square by 2, and by simplifying we get pi by 2. Now an is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x cos nx dx, which is equal to 1 by pi. First we will take the limit integration from 0 to pi x cos nx dx plus integration from pi to 2 pi 2 pi minus x cos nx dx. Now here again we are applying integration by part, keeping x as it is, and integration of cos nx is sin nx by n minus derivative of x is 1, and integration of sin nx by n is minus cos nx by n square with the limit 0 to pi, plus now integration of the second, again 2 pi minus x as it is, integration of cos nx is sin nx by n minus minus 1 into integration of sin nx by n is minus cos nx by n square with the limit pi to 2 pi, which is equal to 1 by pi. Now putting the limit for first part, we know sin of n pi is 0, therefore first part is 0, this minus minus plus cos n pi by n square, and for lower limit because we don't know sin 0 is 0, and 0 we get minus 0, and cos 0 is 1, that is minus minus plus 1 by n square, plus putting the limit in the second part, putting x equal to 2 pi, first part will be 0, that is minus into minus into minus, we get minus cos of 2n pi by n square, minus of lower limit, as we know sin 0 is 0, minus cos of n pi by n square, which is equal to 1 by pi into minus cos of n pi is minus 1 raised to n by n square, minus 1 by n square, and cos of 2n pi is 1, that is minus 1 by n square plus minus 1 raised to n upon n square. By simplifying it, 2 by pi n square into bracket minus 1 raised to n minus 1. Now similarly we will calculate bn. Bn is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of x sin nx dx, which is equal to 1 by pi integration from 0 to pi x sin nx dx plus integration from pi to 2 pi 2 pi minus x into sin nx dx, which is equal to, again using integration by part, 1 by pi, keeping x as it is, and integration of sin nx is minus cos nx by n, minus derivative of x is 1, and integration of minus cos nx by n is minus sin nx by n square with the limit 0 to pi, plus integral of the second, that is keeping 2 pi minus x as it is, and integration of sin nx is minus cos nx by n, minus derivative of 2 pi minus x is minus 1 into integration of minus cos nx by n is minus sin nx by n square with the limit pi to 2 pi. Now by putting the limit we get bn equal to 1 by pi minus pi cos n pi divided by n plus 0 minus, for lower limit we get 0 plus, for upper limit we get both terms are 0 minus into bracket minus cos n pi by n minus 0, which is equal to 1 by pi, we know minus pi into cos of n pi is minus 1 raised to n divided by n plus pi into minus 1 raised to n by n, and which is equal to what we get, 0. Therefore f of x is equal to, here n naught is pi by 2 plus summation of n equal to 1 to infinity, n is 2 by pi n square into bracket minus 1 raised to n minus 1 into cos nx plus bn, that is 0 sin nx. By simplifying we get f of x is equal to pi by 2 plus 2 by pi into summation of n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n minus 1 upon n square cos nx.